Raspberry Pi have just announced a new AI kit. It brings AI capabilities to your Raspberry Pi 5 and costs just $70. But how does it stack up against other boards such as the Google Coral? Let's take a closer look. Hey robot makers, the Raspberry Pi AI kit bundles the Raspberry Pi M2 hat with the Halo AI acceleration module for use with the Raspberry Pi 5. It provides an accessible and cost-effective, power-efficient way to integrate high-performance AI. In the box we have the Halo module, the hat, the mounting hardware, and also a stacking GPIO header. The Halo 8L module contains a neural processing unit and can perform up to 13 tera operations per second or tops of inference performance. It connects to the Raspberry Pi 5 over the PCIe Generation 3 connection, and it's able to share this inference engine across multiple cameras concurrently. Now let's compare this with the Google Coral. Google Coral can perform up to 4 tops compared to the 13 of the Halo, and the Coral is also tightly integrated with the TensorFlow Lite ecosystem and performs at 2 tops per watt. The Halo 8 on the other hand can perform up to 13 tops and is 3 times faster than the Coral, and it actually has a more efficient core with 3 tops per watt. It also has a broader support for neural network frameworks. The price for the AI kit is $70. Let's unbox this and assemble the kit. Raspberry Pi also sent me all the other bits and pieces, such as a Raspberry Pi 5, the power supply, the card with the pre-release software on, as well as the kit itself. Oh, and also a camera module 3, so we can actually try out this and have a demo. So this is the AI kit box itself, and as you can see when I open this up, it has the M2 hat, and they've already pre-loaded, pre-attached the Halo module to it. One of the other nice things about this board is that little cutout there for the camera cables, so it's very easy to attach cameras with this particular hat. So I'm just going to attach this riser, which just gives it an extra bit of height, and then attach the camera, and we're good to go. I've just attached this small monitor that I have on my desk, just to test that the camera's working. You can see me waving there. Great! So this version of Raspberry Pi OS has the updated libraries in it, so when I run the RPI Cam Hello program, it can do some post-processing using the AI module. So you can see there it's detecting me as a person, and I'm holding various different things up to the camera to see if it can detect that. And this is currently running at 30 frames per second. Now this isn't a test of the models themselves and how accurate they are, this is simply just taking all that workload and putting it through the AI module, so our main CPU can carry on doing other tasks instead. It is worth noting just how smooth this is. It can detect multiple objects at the same time without breaking a sweat. There are a couple of different models that we can use, the YOLO 5, YOLO 8, and YOLO X as well. For some reason it's detecting toilet at the top there. It thinks that light is a toilet. There's also a segmentation model that we can run as well, and you'll be able to see that in a second. It was quite late when I recorded this, hence the strange expression on my face. You can see there with this segmentation, it's done quite a good job of splitting me out from the background there. There is a bit of noise, but it does work quite well. And then finally we have this one, which is the pose estimation. You can see me doing a bit of a dance there as well. Like I said, it was late. So I hope you enjoyed this short video about the AI kit. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I shall see you next time. Bye for now.